In this video, we're going to compare the Deepcool AK620 to the Scythe Fuma 2 Rev-B CPU coolers using machine learning on over a million data points. The information in this video can also be found on my website at pcanalytics.com, and the product links can be found in the description below. With that in mind, let's look at some qualitative metrics. Both CPU cooler images show the side of the cooler that would face the RAM. With that in mind, the AK620 cooler will overhang the RAM slots in most setups, while the Fuma 2 will not have RAM clearance issues in most setups. Additionally, both coolers each use two 120mm fans, and it is possible to add additional fans on both coolers. In regards to installation, both coolers are relatively easy to install. Next, let's dig into the performance. We're going to cover two sets of graphs, one normalized by percent speeds and the second normalized by noise levels. Note that these graphs are created by using machine learning models to help break down the performance using over a million data points in an open case. This means that performance may differ depending on your case's airflow and your CPU. To orient you to the graph, the left side shows temperatures corresponding to the solid lines, with the right side showing noise levels represented by the dashed lines. As a general rule, lower is always better for the data shown. With that in mind, we will first look at the fan's performance on an idle CPU, which is assumed to be using 30 watts of power. When comparing the AK620 cooler in red to the Fuma 2 cooler in blue, both coolers perform similarly across the board in terms of cooling. However, the AK620 begins to start to make audible noise around 40% fan speed. As we increase the watts to 105, which is what the CPU is rated for, we can see that the AK620 has better cooling performance at lower RPMs, but that difference shrinks to minimal levels as we increase to 100% fan speed. Next, we will look at the CPU overclocked to 125 watts. This shows that the coolers can handle overclock temperatures well, with the AK620 cooler being slightly cooler at higher RPMs. For the second set of comparisons, we will look at the performance for a given noise level. The graph shown has noise on the bottom axis while keeping the temperatures on the side axis. Note that lower is still better for this graph. When comparing the coolers by normalized noise levels, we see that both coolers perform similarly across the board. As we increase the watts to 105, we can see that the Cooler Master AK620 begins to slightly outperform at higher decimal levels. As we increase the watts to 125, we can see that this trend continues. Overall, the AK620 cooler has slightly better cooling performance for a given noise level, making it the winner for this comparison. If you enjoyed this video, you should check out this one. Thank you for watching.